What's going on, music producers? It's Curtis King of Airbid.com here to answer the question today. What genre of music is my new beat? Let's talk about it.
Airbid.com.
Music producers, it's very important that you categorize your beats appropriately. Now, when I say appropriately, I mean there's numerous genres, especially on Airbit. There's numerous genres that you can categorize your beats as such. You can make it new wave, you can make it hip hop, you can make it trap, you can make it pop, you can make it R&B. But every so once in a while, there's producers who make certain beats that can be categorized in multiple categories. And so it leaves us in a bit of a confusion because we're trying to figure out how do I properly categorize this beat and put it in the genre that's most likely going to equal out to sales. At least that's the way that you want to approach it. So as you're looking through your beats, you're listening to your beats, it's important before you start to categorize it by what you may categorize it as, it's important that you understand what the general population understands these genres to be. Now, just because certain words, you know, like new wave, just because you may figure like, hey, this beat is new and it's wavy, it must be new wave. That's not necessarily what new wave is. And if you start to look at the definition of some of these genres, you'll realize they have very definitive styles and definitive sounds. And obviously, we know we're living in the day and the age where most music is kind of meshed together anyways, but it's important for you from a marketing standpoint to know what kind of beats you make, because although trap beats are under the umbrella of this culture called hip hop, every trap beat is not a hip hop beat, and every hip hop beat cannot be classified as a trap beat. It just wouldn't make any sense. You know, there's certain instrument choices. You want to go ahead and pay attention to some of these Wikipedia accounts and, you know, really listen to some of the pioneers of these genres within interviews and videos and properly put your music there. Because here's the thing about it. When you put your music out there as a certain genre, you're saying that you're, you know, subconsciously, you're saying that you want to attract a certain type of demographic. You're saying, hey, I make these dark trap beats or this dark wave. Make sure you know what you're putting in, first of all. You're putting in these certain sounds of beats. You're saying, I want to attract this demographic because they're more than likely not going to just like this beat. They're going to like the majority of the beats in here because we're of the same sort of energetic wavelength. So as you put your beats together, I suggest if you've never done this before, do some research. And then do some research as trends change. You know, what was hip hop 10 years ago may not necessarily be the same hip hop as it is today. So it's important for you to pay attention to new albums, pay attention to their categorization, and just see, are these beats in the proper genre? But those are my thoughts about it. We would love to hear your thoughts. Please comment below about how you specifically figure out the genres of music that are appropriate for the beats that you make. We encourage engagement. Please comment below. Once again, it's Curtis King of Airbit.com. Have a good one.
Airbit.com.
Music producers, don't forget to subscribe to the Airbit channel right now.